On the right-hand side of your screen, you see the title, Feasible Region Graphing with desmos.com/calculator. A student showed me this website last semester for graphing linear inequalities, and I really appreciated it for several reasons. I'll begin by taking the first linear inequality and typing it in the input bar. On the left-hand side of the screen is the input bar. X plus 4y is less than or equal to 28. You type the less than as one symbol, the equals as a second, and the program puts it all together. The other thing that it does is it graphs the line immediately while you're typing. So I'm going to zoom out for the reason that my y-intercept is at 7 and my x-intercept is at 28. So I can see those when I zoom out. We'll also notice that Desmos shades the true side of a linear inequality, and that's typical. Now I'm going to add a second one. X plus y is less than or equal to 10. Now it shades it in a different color, which is nice, and I can see that the two shaded regions overlap kind of in this bluish gray area in the first quadrant. I add a third one. 3x plus y is less than or equal to 24. This time it's green. We imagine where the red, blue, and green overlap, it is down in the smaller region in the first quadrant. I also have x is greater than or equal to 0. That's the purple one. And lastly, I have y is greater than or equal to 0. A lot of times people will leave off the graphs of x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0 because those two linear inequalities are just forcing you to look at the first quadrant, and to leave them off would clean up the graph. So I'm going to go ahead and delete those off, making it easier to find. And the feasible region is where the green, blue, and pink overlap in just that first quadrant. And I can click on where the two lines intersect to get a point of intersection. And if I feel more comfortable, I can always zoom back and grab and slide. So I can click on that point and find out that that point is ordered pair 7, 3. And I could also click up here to find out that that ordered pair is 4, 6. If I needed to know some other values, say where the red and blue meet, I could click there and see, that's on the y-intercept, but that's 0, 7. So I have a 0, 7, a 4, 6, a 7, 3, 8, 0, and 0, 0 for where the vertices are of my feasible region. So this website is really useful for graphing the inequalities quickly and also finding the points of intersection, which are the vertices of the feasible region.